Have you ever in your own life had a romance or relationship that was predicated a lot on writing or letters or anything like that? Hi, I'm Maureen Lee Lenker with Entertainment Weekly, and we're talking Dash and Lily.
Imagine you're in New York, and it's Christmas. You're in your favorite bookstore, and there is a red notebook. Do you dare?
So much of the chemistry and this love story is crafted through voiceover and through writing each other back and forth. How does that change or complicate your performance because you're not actually getting to be face to face on screen and build that with each other?
Midori and I seem to have like a natural good chemistry. We did keep like a notebook between us in terms of like kind of sharing intimate things about one another.
Austin's my friend, and we connected right away and both cared a lot about our show. And so we had a lot of late night talks and stuff, and it was very easy to like feel him with me. And a lot of the scenes that you're watching where I'm alone or he's alone, we have the narration kind of in our head. So it's kind of easy to imagine that person's with you.
When you were first getting going with this project, what was your initial impressions of the character?
I was really excited to play a queer character whose main arc wasn't this like, you know, self-identity crisis or dealing with, you know, not being accepted by themselves or their family and friends. I think that even though that is a very common journey, unfortunately, with a lot of the queer community, I think it's important to show a character that is just unapologetically themselves, and it's not questioned by themselves or their friends or their family. I think that's a really important message of hope.
And I haven't played anybody like this yet in my time of like acting in my career. So me, I'm always trying to jump to the next thing that's completely different than what I've played before, and just enhancing my energy to embody this character. Cause really I'm a cool and calm, collected guy. I really had to tap in and just do something different as far as how I'm bringing things to the table. I remember going to my audition with Brad, and he just wanted more and more energy out of me. And that was showing me like in my test, how far and how much I could go, how far I can bring this character.
I got to play such a bubbly, hopeful, optimistic person. And I have that person within me, but like not necessarily always at like 5 in the morning. So for me, the challenge was like, how do I make sure that that's real and that's present in me at all times?
He hates Christmas.
Get out of my room.
It's the most detestable time of the year. The forced cheer, the frenzied crowd.
Put the book back on the shelf and try again.
Can you guys tell me more about filming on location in New York City during the holidays, because it just seems like it must have been the most magical thing ever.
So we started filming in October of last year, and it was not Christmas yet. And we had like, it was a bit trippy actually, because the snowbanks, our props department's amazing. It was so realistic. So we'd have like Christmas trees lined up on the bodega, and there was this one woman, an angry New Yorker, so to speak, who was really, really upset that we had Christmas trees out. And when I told her, she did not care. But so we kind of had to like insert the holidays into the city even before it happened. And then slowly the weather started dropping and the actual Christmas start, and then it kind of just collided. But it was awesome.
I think that we realized while we were shooting last year that it would have this feeling of nostalgia, because we obviously had no idea that we were going to be in a global pandemic. Yeah, I think because the holidays are not going to be the same this year, our show offers that escape, and it has a very nostalgic feeling, even though it's set now. There was like a montage where our family had a Christmas party, and we're all wearing matching pajamas, and it's just a montage, but it ends with this family photo. And it's really special to me because they show the photo for like 0.5 seconds, but it's just, you know, we have our Japanese family and our white family, and then me and Midori in the middle, and it's all interspersed. And it was just like, there was no division. It was just a group of people. And it was like, here's a family. I don't know. That just felt like a really beautiful, special moment to really hit home that like, hey, families sometimes look like this.
The strand is really core to the storytelling here, and it really bookends the show. It begins and ends there. Can you just tell me more about what it was like shooting in such an iconic landmark?
It was just so cool. It was cool to be like, you know, it's New York. When are you going to be in a store like that when it's empty?
Yeah, I feel like everyone knows the Strand is a little bit like romanticized in terms of like a bookstore in New York. So I think it definitely like lends itself.
The show's kind of coming out in the wake of the store saying that they're not doing so hot like most indie bookstores right now, and they need their customers' help and support. How do you guys feel about Dash and Lily sort of being an unintentional ad for The Strand in some ways, or a way to encourage people to support the bookstore?
I think it's just about awareness, because anyone who I've talked to who I tell like, oh, The Strand is going to shut down, they immediately order something online if they have the means. So I feel like I feel like we just have to get word out, and I think people will come and save it, I hope.
I love how they tied The Strand into the story, and they're giving a business like that, a small business, to a chance to get some traction in New York, especially right now.
Yeah, I mean, I've lived in New York for 6 years, and The Strand is definitely a staple of the city. I know a lot of people that just hang out there, and you know, it's a kind of a place of refuge for a lot of people to go and find a new book or something like that. Our show also, it shows the very mainstream touristy places of New York City, but it sprinkles in some lesser known places, and I think that makes it really unique and special.
Thank you so much, you guys, and happy holidays.
Thank you so much.
Happy holidays.
Thank you.